vacation, you want a boat, you want a toy of some kind, a luxury item, you do that after the emergency fund is completed, and only then.
Okay. You saw the story that came out that said there's a new study that says people who make $75,000 a year are happier. Mm-hmm. Kind of that's the baseline for where you become happy, and more money doesn't necessarily make you happy. What do you think about that?
Well, it's an interesting study, and you know, I guess it's somewhat true. I don't know that you can nail it to $75,000 exactly. I meet plenty of people that make $40,000 and have learned to live on less than that, who are very, very happy. Mm-hmm. And I meet people who make $200,000 and are spending $300,000 and they're miserable.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So
right.
It has to do with being in control of your money and being proactive, using the old budget, and be communicating with your spouse, for those of us that are married. The sense of control, the sense of destiny, the sense of being a grown-up is probably a higher propensity to happiness than the actual dollar amount.
And living within your means, I mean, mm-hmm. that brings joy in and of itself.
Yeah.
It really does. And, you know, Grandma and Grandpa, they were simple folk, and they did fine. They were happy people. I mean, a fried piece of bologna and a fresh tomato, everybody was happy, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Hey, everything's good then. There's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to make a lot of money to be like that. And so it's not about the amount. It's about learning to live on less than that and engaging in the simple pleasures regardless of what you make.